I was so excited to finally get to see the wild horses from the Theodore Roosevelt National Park in North Dakota. On my first day out, I saw this band belonging to the beautiful gray stallion named Teton. He had two foals that were about 3 weeks old. They were hanging out in a prairie dog town near the entrance of the park. The chirping you hear are the prairie dogs sounding their alarms. The horses were far away, but it was still nice to be able to see them. The next day, I found these bachelor stallions together. The roan stallion was beautiful, with one blue eye. Further into the park, I came across a pair of horses, a gray stallion, and a chestnut mare. The stallion kept chasing the mare, who appeared to be in foal. They soon disappeared out of sight. I found them in the same area the next day, and they seemed quite content just to graze and rest. Since they were close to the road, I could see how thin and beat up the stallion was. I later found out his name is Gray Ghost, and he had been fighting off other stallions all spring and summer, and finally lost his band except for the chestnut mare Twister. It was nice to know he was able to have one mare left. On the third day of looking for horses, I came across another band of five mares and a 2-year-old colt standing on a hill. They belong to this sorrel stallion named Flax, who has a beautiful flaxen mane and tail. He apparently stole these mares from another stallion named Ranger, who stole them from Gray Ghost the week before I got there. So goes the life of a wild Mustang stallion. I was so happy I was able to observe this band for over an hour. Soon they took off and disappeared over the hill. Hopefully, I can return again next year and look for more wild mustangs.